Welcome back to Skate Canada International, presented by Artistry Skincare and Cosmetics. A new season with a changing landscape, particularly in the pairs. And with more from the K-Rock Center here in Kingston, here's Brenda Irving.
Well, Scott, the landscape has certainly changed for Megan DeHamel. You know, a lot of people thought her last competitive skate might have been in March at the Four Continents competition when her and Craig Button finished in third place. Well, she thought she was done as well, but then someone said, why don't you work with 25-year-old Eric Radford? And she did, and they've certainly gelled together very quickly. But as they'll tell you, patience is a virtue.
This is a marathon. It's not a sprint. We're not... We weren't in it to win Nebelhorn in Germany, you know, like we're in this for the Olympics, we're in it for the long haul. So of course you need patience for that. But at the same time, you know, like when we were starting to train together, everything was very exciting. Every time we did something, we didn't want to have to wait like a month before we tried something. We wanted to do it right away.
And one of the things that makes them such a strong team is they are great singles skaters. Both have won the Canadian Junior Championships in singles before, and technically their program is really strong. In fact, they're going to try a side-by-side triple Lutz. If they complete it, they'll be only the third team in Grand Prix history to do that, Scott.
Thank you very much, Brenda. Well, it's an interesting story. Megan DeHamel paired with Craig Button last season, and they got quite a ways in terms of international competition. But Craig is gone now. Megan stays on with Eric Radford. They have the tools as a pair.
Yes, they do. They have a great mix of strengths. You know, Megan is so feisty, and she loves to jump. She loves to be thrown. It's just all about excitement for her. Whereas Eric, he's more the artist, and he too is a great jumper, but he's got beautiful long lines. He's just a little more calm and easy, does it. And I think they can bring out the best in each other. It's such early going for these two. They really don't understand how they compete yet and what they have to do to be in the right competitive mind. But I think it's really going to bring out the best in these two in the long run.
Injury to Bryce Davison, and so Jessica Dubé and Bryce Davison not competing here at Skate Canada. That was a late call. But this is a Canadian tradition, Kurt. Canada's always been strong in the pairs competition, and now youth comes up.
And always our pairs, especially in my generation, had great personalities. And that's what I think you find in our young teams. Kirsten and Dylan there getting ready to compete have this vibrant faces. They really exude so much joy within their skating. They have wonderful lift that goes on for about 16 minutes in a 3-minute program. It's fantastic. It's really exciting. And the other team, Paige and Rudy, also bring that youthful effervescence. They have what they call, I think, the missile dismount from one of their lifts that just looks like, well, that's the end of her. And it's very, very exciting stuff.
It was reminding us of the late 80s and 90s with Huff and Ledre and Brasseur and Eisler. Crowd-pleasing pair teams and wonderful energetic routines.
Is this the most dangerous, daring of the disciplines because there are so many component parts?
The only way to make it more dangerous is to make him a hockey player. But yeah,
what do you
absolutely.
Know about that?
They make it look so easy until something goes wrong, and then it just looks like the reality of gravity and speed comes into play.
And the necessary ingredient for the females in the pair discipline, you have to be fearless. And all of these skaters all of these women are, they just go for it. They love to be thrown. Kirsten said, there's nothing I like better than a good throw.
What about the Americans here, Simpson and Miller? Can they be a factor in this competition? Looks like Canada's position at home.
I end up watching her all the time and on practice this week, and I haven't really seen or given much of my attention to him. So there's a mismatch there as far as I'm concerned. Again, she just looks like she's another one of those pair girls, just looks so happy in a dangerous place.
And what you have to remember in the pairs, especially early in the season, there are so many high-risk moves. Errors can be numerous, and the standings can get shaken up right in a hurry.
There are the coaches over the boards. Chris Wirtz there, a former Canadian champion.
Lyndon Johnson
competition.
There.
Yeah, Lyndon Johnson, who's from Manitoba, by the way. It has a connection to Lawrence and Swiegers here from that part of the country. And you know what? This is a tremendously exciting competition, and it's wide open, as we talked about at the top of the show, with the absence of Dubé Davison.
Well, we've got, we've got three Canadian teams, and we don't really know the pecking order yet. We don't really know how those teams are going to mesh together, and it all sort of starts here. National seems a long way away, but we're talking about Sochi, which is like 4 years away.
Right.
So what we need to do is sit back and enjoy those three teams trying to figure out, all right, who's our number one team here?
And these three teams, they know they're in the spotlight, and it's theirs to step up and grab here. That even puts the pressure on more.
A tremendously expectant crowd here at the K-Rock Center in Kingston, Ontario, particularly because Cynthia Phaneuf has taken the short program lead, and now we focus in on the Canadian pairs, and there are three of them. Duhamel and Radford, Moore Towers and Moscovich, Lawrence and Swiggers, and also Simpson Miller of the United States will be skating in this first flight of the pairs competition. Now the final moments before you take to the ice, and these have to be nervous times for the skaters as this Grand Prix season kicks into high gear in Kingston.
And especially for Megan and Eric, because as I said earlier, they don't know how they like to compete. Eric doesn't know, does she like to be quiet? Does she need to be alone, or does she need me to pump her up? And that's something that they'll have to find as the season progresses.
Anything I know about Megan, I doubt she needs...
You got to calm her.
Yeah, you got to calm her
Maybe
down.
Maybe we should have talked to him.
Representing Canada, Megan Duhamel and Eric Radford.
Couple of 25 years old from Northern Ontario. He's from Bomberton, which is near the Manitoba border. She's from Lively, Ontario, small community not far from North Bay. They train in Saint Leonard with Richard Gauthier and Bruno Marcotte. And that was where she trained along with Craig Bonten, her former partner.
Skating two for one voice. Twist to open. Now they move ahead to side-by-side triples, and this the most difficult side-by-side triple Lutzes.
Change in plan for double Lutz. Sometimes we talk about skaters popping open in the air, popping down to an easier jump. It looked like that was a planned double Lutz.
The call whether or not to stay in the game after Craig retired. Together they just missed that Olympic spot for Vancouver. She was tremendously disappointed by that, but the fighter in her brings her back.
Tracy, that they look pretty good together in a sport where good men pair skaters are as hard to find as a gold stream in a mountain wall. He's doing great, and I love their costuming. I love the choice of music. Get that triple twist going, and we got some team players here.
First out of the gate is a tough position to be in. And this new partnership of Megan Duhamel and Eric Radford somehow make it work at the K-Rock Center in Kingston. You're watching
Ladies
Skate Canada on.
Excellent skate.
Yeah. The loss was actually quite good as well.
Welcome back to Skate Canada International in Kingston. Scott Russell along with Tracy Wilson, Kurt Browning, and Brenda Irving. Awaiting their marks, Megan Duhamel and Eric Radford of Canada.
So they did a beautiful double twist instead of a triple. The side-by-side triple Lutzis, he did a triple, she did a double. That will hurt them technically. Other than that, Kurt, I thought it was a really nice first impression for this senior Grand Prix for this team.
We got 51 in Germany.
And their marks in the short program, a 54.8.
The next competitors, representing Canada, Kirsten Moore Towers and Dylan Moskovich.
Second duo of Canadians, Kirsten Moore Towers and Dylan Moskovich. She's 18, he's 26. From the Golden Triangle.
They will skate to Zorba the Greek. Can you hear that peppy music? Kirsten says this program is me through and through.
She's like the cheerleader of figure skating. Super high energy and a super high twist. Three revolutions in the air.
Last year at Skate Canada in Kitchener, and that's home ice for them. They were sixth. They're trained by the two-time Canadian pairs champions, Chris and Christy Wirtz.
Difficult entry to this lift.
Now for a throw triple loop. For the first time in the program, they looked cautious going in and then tentative on the landing. Job of playing to their strengths.
Well, there is certainly an energy and excitement in the partnership. Now, if they can get it clicking on all
Ladies
cylinders,
from Canada,
we'll return to Towers Kingston and Skate Canada and in a moment. Welcome back to Kingston. Kirsten Moore Towers and Dylan Moskovich awaiting their marks. Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swiegers of Canada are on the ice, warming up, getting ready to go. As we return to the kiss and cry, there's Chris Wirtz.
Kirsten telling Christy, her other coach at home through the TV set during the commercial, I didn't stand up. I don't think she had a lot of choice. That throw looked a little bit off outside the circle, as we call it. Difficult to hold your balance when you're out there in no man's land.
53-6-8 for Moore Towers and Moskovich of Canada.
And Rudy
from Saskatchewan,
Swiegers.
Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swiegers. She's from Kennedy, he's from Kipling. They represent the Wawota Figure Skating Club, and they're coached by Patty Hole.
And they will skate to music from City Slickers, and they've gone to the world of ice dance to borrow choreographers. Cronin Poirier's coaches, Carol Lane and Yuri Razguliev, have choreographed this.
Well, the one thing that team does is always choose a good vehicle to showcase the talents. So the personalities, I expect, pop into your TV screen on this one. Showcase that move.
Now this is an element that they've had trouble with, been inconsistent in practice, the side-by-side, triple toes, triple salchows. Again, a little off on the landing.
Their club is 5 hours southeast of Saskatoon. And at the Canadian Championships in Saskatoon a couple of years ago, they lit it up. They were fourth. Johnson, Patty Hole, their coaches. She's from a rodeo family. He's born in Cape Town, South Africa. They're all Saskatchewan now. Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swiegers will return to Kingston.
Happy birthday, Howard.
Happy birthday, Howard.
Happy birthday, Howard. We return now to the K-Rock Center in Kingston, Ontario. Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swiegers of Canada awaiting their marks. That's Lyndon Johnson beside Rudy. Patty Hole beside Paige. And their marks are a 56-14.
Good job.
Puts them into the lead over their Canadian friends and rivals.
The next competitors representing
Lawrence Swiegers, DeHamel Redford, Moortowers, Moskovich, 1, 2, 3. Miller. And on the ice now, the Americans, Brittany Simpson and Nathan Miller. She's only 14 years of age.
They will skate to the Pink Panther.
I think that's a rite of passage that every skater has to skate to the Pink Panther at least once, right?
Did you?
Of course.
Side-by-side double axles. Good fight.
They were fifth at the most recent World Junior Championships and got the call to come here to Kingston and skate Canada very late, just a week ago.
And this is all about experience. As Scott said, Brittany's only 14 years of age, and this is their debut on the Senior Grand Prix circuit.
Some skaters just seem to relish the moment. They love the competition. I get the feeling that Brittany loves every single second she's skating. With which they skate their stroking and actually hide some of the flaws within their skating skills.
The young Americans, she's from Denver, Colorado. He's from Little Rock, Arkansas.
From the United States
and now they train
America,
in Colorado Springs, Brittany Simpson and Nathan Miller, center ice.
Kurt, you talked about this piece of music and how it was clever for them, and it was because it allowed their personalities. They could play with their bodies and their arms in it, and it hid some of their flaws. And that would be the basic skating skills, the turnout of the free leg and the exact match, which is so important and is a long time in coming in the pair skating, the refinement of those elements.
Take a look at the individual jumps here. What you'll see is not a lot of quality on the landings. Both landings needing a little bit of effort, that not touch and flow feeling that you're wanting, especially when the jump is only a double axel, the technically difficult jumps deserve more respect.
Here, the triple twist,
short.
Not quite getting the height to do the full rotation, but it is important that they start doing the triple twist in the competition. And now the throw triple salchow, good height, but her shoulders got ahead of her feet and over-rotated on the landing. So just little glitches, and those things add up. A lot of that just comes from the extra adrenaline of being out in a competition like this.
8 years separate them in terms of age. Helping to bring them together is their coach Larry Ibarra, who is with them in the kiss and cry. And now the marks for the Americans, Simpson and Miller.
The short program.
Survey says.
46. And they're down at 46.39 behind all three Canadian pairs. 46.39 for Brittany Simpson and Nathan Miller of USA. And so the way it stands at this point in the short program, pairs competition at Skate Canada, Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swiegers have the lead, 56.14, followed by Megan Duhamel and Eric Radford. Kirsten Moore-Towers, Dylan Moskovich, also of Canada, in third spot, and then it's Simpson Miller of the United States in fourth.